420 has come and gone, but this year the park has stayed clean. Plus how you can check out city resources at a North Denver library. I'm Rebecca Jacobson, and here's what's happening in your city now. Now you can find more than just books at the Valdez Perry Library. The North Denver Resource Center is now open to help all Denver residents find what they need.
With services to help them find jobs, sign up for food and health care assistance, get help obtaining funding for school or training, or to start their own business, and so much more will be housed here as part of this one-stop center.
Denverites just need to stop in.
What we're really hoping is have an avalanche of people coming in through these doors to access these services. We have staffing support at all open hours of the library. So from Monday through Fridays, when the library is open, we will have staff here, city staff here, to provide resources. We have so many great resources as a city, but people may not know about them. People may be afraid to walk through the doors of the Webb building, to go to the Castro building. So I think to be in a center that is trusted to remove those barriers in a library was a really great opportunity. We're really excited.
You can check it out for yourself. You can find a full list of services at denvergov.org or at denverlibrary.org.
How do we have an inmate die? The city pays $4.65 million to the family, agrees to policy changes, but yet there's no discipline assessed.
At a recent committee meeting, the new director of safety responded to the Independent Monitor's report on the city's response to Michael Marshall's death in the Denver jail in 2015.
If we're serious about long-term public safety, we have to be serious about mental health issues, we have to be serious about reentrance, and we have to do this on a global point of public safety, and not just in the jail, not just in the police department. It has to be a new philosophical shift in the way we do business as public safety.
The monitor's report criticized the relatively minor discipline the Department of Safety recommended for only some involved officers, while longtime department officials point to bad policy rather than bad actors as the main culprit. You may have noticed some of your colleagues wearing their jeans to work on Wednesday, and this week they were doing it for a good cause, because City Council declared April 25th as Denim Day.
Denim Day, just so you know, came about out of a travesty of justice. A young 18-year-old girl was raped, and the judge deemed it not to be rape because her jeans were too tight. And we took that and we turned it into a celebration and a show of support for survivors, because we love to see your pictures, because we know each picture that you upload wearing your jeans means you believe and you support us. And hopefully that will mean there will be one less victim next year.
Those who wore their denim on Wednesday donated $5 to the Colorado Coalition Against Sexual Assault. You can donate to the cause at any time at coloradogives.org/ccasa. The morning of April 21st, Civic Center Park was clean, serene, and showed no trace of the 420 rally and festival held the day before. After a much-publicized fight with last year's event planners, who left the park in disarray, this year's winning organizers, Euphora Dispensary, made sure to clean up after the thousands of attendees without delay. An estimated 70,000 people enjoyed major music artists, food vendors, and other entertainment in the center of the city. Among the crowds who braved the wet weather, Denver police offered security and some enforcement, issuing 63 marijuana consumption citations, nearly twice as many as last year. Help keep Colfax clean and beautiful. Register for the Great Colfax Cleanup happening May 19th from 9 a.m. to 12:30. There's a raffle for prizes and a strangest piece of litter competition. And of course, there will be refreshments. Register at denvergov.org under Trash and Recycling. Powwows are the Native American people's way of meeting together to join in singing, dancing, visiting, and making new friendships. And the 8th annual New Beginnings Powwow on May 12th will be one to remember. The event will feature plenty of learning opportunities such as Native American jewelry and crafts, food, and traditional dancing. The powwow is free and open to all. Join in at the Magnus Arena on the University of Denver campus. You can catch a new episode of Your City Now every Friday. Thanks for watching, Denver.